does feel a little bit weird to be starting a new year of school in April. Usually school start times are like September, or even January would feel a little bit more normal, I think, than April. But Rhodes has rolling semesters, and so they accept new students every 3 months, and I started my first year at the beginning of April, and so naturally, I would also be starting my second year at the beginning of April. It still feels weird though. Also, because the program runs 18 months straight, as those of you who watched my video last week know, I just finished my first year last Thursday. And so I had the weekend and then I'm right back at Rhodes. So not much of a break. It's a very quick turnaround, but it is definitely a new year because it feels completely different than first year. First of all, my schedule has changed. Instead of going during the days, I now have night class. Monday through Thursday, we go from 5 until 9, and then on Fridays, we come in from 12 until 4. A couple of my classmates are finding the time change a little bit difficult. They are getting a little bit sleepy and dozing off in class. I myself have found the adjustment really nice, actually. I worked in the service industry for years, and so I'm used to kind of coming alive at 5 p.m., you know, to schmooze my tables to try to prize their money from them. So the time change has actually really worked with my ingrained sort of energy cycles of highs and lows. I'm on a high right when I'm in class, which is perfect because it keeps me really alert, and I need to be because there is a lot of information to absorb. I have mentioned this several times before, but Rhodes is an experiential learning experience for the first 12 months, meaning that you learn the material by practicing it on yourself as well as your classmates. So there is a huge self-analysis going on the entire time where everything that you learn, you have to personalize it and then dissect yourself a little bit and see how it applies to your own life, decisions, and behavior patterns. Second year is not like this. I mean, it's not a full-blown lecture style like you would get in university. There's only 10 of us in the class, so there still is a lot more discussion and dialogue than there would be in a gigantic lecture hall. However, we are being given the information and we are absorbing it more as counselors in training as opposed to just regular people that could apply this to our own lives. Whereas in first year, it was like, here is some new information, now how can I apply that to, yes, a counseling setting, but also to me in my own life as a human being. Whereas second year is like, here is a bunch of information and you need to absorb it like a counselor and how this will be relevant to your clients and your practice. It feels much more academic and professional. I like it a lot. We also have more classes. So in first year, the entire semester, you'd pretty much be doing the same thing. Whereas in second year, we have a different class every day of the week. So for this semester, I have ethics, grief and loss counseling, lifestyle management and program planning, human development, and supervision hours with some business development training. Each class certainly has its own flavor, so I will do my best over the coming months to try to focus one video on a particular class so you can sort of get an idea of what we're doing in each one. This week was mostly just introductions, we got our syllabus, and we met our teachers. So it wasn't super exciting or juicy yet, but I know there'll be a lot of really cool information coming down the pipeline. So stay tuned and I will share that with you here. That's all I have for you today for a little lesson or a little introduction to second year and a touch of insight. Thank you for tuning in and I will see you next week.